I'm Ray Vaughan. I'm an environmental scientist here in Buffalo. Talking today about the Skyway Bridge here in Buffalo. And you may have seen this slide in some of the other presentations today. This is a picture of the Skyway. It's the curving bridge that you see moving away from you. It comes down into downtown Buffalo. It crosses the Buffalo River. In the background, you can see the frozen surface of Lake Erie and the New York shore extending into the western distance. CNU, this is the issue. CNU and others call for the Skyway to come down. This is part of the Freeways Without Futures report that came out this year. But that view is really misguided. They're really two separate Skyway issues. One is the question of removing the traffic. The other is whether, once that's done, whether to demolish or repurpose the Skyway. And one of the compelling features of the Skyway is that it really offers 8 acres of extra waterfront open space that wouldn't otherwise be there. Here's a view of the Skyway deck. You can see the Skyway in the distance curving around the white grain elevator, which is behind the Skyway. When I say behind, I mean behind relative to Lake Erie, which is the main view of importance. At the top, you can see some statistics. The issue is in blue. Main one, of course, is demolish or repurpose once the traffic is removed. Repurposing certainly has a good prior example, the High Line in New York City. One of the issues is certainly whether view sheds at the surface are being blocked. This is minimal due to the Skyway's location and its open structure. And even if there is some blocking of surface view sheds, it's offset by the lake and cityscape views from the Skyway itself. Also, if there are surface uses that are being blocked, those are also going to be offset by new uses on the Skyway, and those are also minimal because of the Skyway's height and its relatively narrow footprint. Cost is high. Can't really talk about that in any detail today, but it's high for either demolition or repurposing. So that's not a clear-cut determinant. Skyway also adds spatial complexity. I see that as a positive. It adds to the urban fabric. Others may not agree, but that is an issue, I think. Here's a map view. You can see a Skyway crossing the Buffalo River between the two red marks. Here's a close-up view, a little closer in. And you can see that the Skyway is primarily behind relative to the lake and or above the waterfront park view sheds. The Skyway is narrow and open, so it doesn't block views as waterfront buildings would. And except for its widely spaced piers, the Skyway doesn't block surface use as Interstate 190 does. 190, as you can see in the darker map view, you can see it's on and off ramps. That's really the culprit for what's taking up a lot of space. Here's just a view showing the view upriver, looking at the grain elevator that's behind the Skyway. Here's another upriver view. You can see the grain elevator in an industrial building, thank you, and the sports arena. And here's a downriver view showing the type of view shed blocking that might occur, but here we are in a light rail yard. It's not a facility that really depends much on view sheds. Even so, when you look toward the lake, what you're seeing is the trees that are at the mouth of the river. The river curves at the mouth, so you're not seeing the lake directly. Here's just a view showing you what the Skyway looks like from Lake Erie. And here are some of the uses and components of a repurposed Skyway. Obviously, things like gardens, bikeway, the views obviously are an important feature. A restaurant ought to be atop, maybe other cafes, shops, and so on. We would certainly want an elevator up from Canalside Park to the top. Some of the other possible uses, but also having it be at least partly a flexible space that could be rearranged or reused as needed. In blue, you can see some of the other examples that you may be familiar with. And we actually had this past Saturday a recent two-hour reuse opportunity. There was a wonderful bicycle tour that went over the Skyway. 1,000 bicycles participated. Beautiful day for it, beautiful reuse of this structure that is normally busy with traffic. Same day, you can get a sense of what the Lake Erie view from near the top of the Skyway is. You can see the sailboats in the background, the western horizon looking toward the far end of the lake, 250 miles away, a little bit of the Canadian shore on the right. Here's another Lake Erie view, actually taken through the windshield last night as I was driving home. Again, you can see on this one the New York shore extending many miles into the distance. And if you turn around 180 degrees, you get the cityscape, so you get this wonderful juxtaposition of views from the top of the Skyway. So conclusions, the two separate issues, replacement of the Skyway and what to do with it afterward. Clearly two separate issues. I've talked about the views. Overall, we need an appropriate balance between the surface impacts, to the extent that they exist, and the views and new uses you get if the skyway is reused. And I think I've shown that there's minimal interference with surface view sheds, minimal interference with surface use. And the last three points here deal with the careful analysis that's really needed prior to any decision on demolition versus repurposing. First, the analysis needs to meet NEPA requirements. Second, the cost is a very important factor. It's high for either demolition or reuse. Obviously, it needs attention more than I can present today. And last but not least, as I mentioned, these 8 acres of additional waterfront surface, or land, if you will, that would be lost if the skyway is demolished. That clearly needs to be part of the analysis. So with that, I'm finished. These are just a few of the prior works that other people have done, which could give you a little more detail, actually, on some of the proposed reuses. But I think you've got enough imagination to see what some of those might be. Thank you.